So what about the fact that some cancer cells do activate autophagy? So how's...
So one relatively general mechanism may be that early during oncogenesis, the deletion of tumor suppressor genes or the activation of oncogenes leads to autophagy suppression. So there are several examples for this. And it is part of the process that leads to cellular transformation, because autophagy is a homeostatic mechanism that, if inhibited, favors genomic instability and malignant transformation of the cells. So there are examples on the literature also that direct inhibition of autophagy is sufficient to cause oncogenesis, in particular in the context of leukemia. Hmm. And so later on, when the cells strive and adapt to an ever more hostile microenvironment, hostile because there's too little vascularization for the expanding cancer cells, so initially there are hypoxic areas, there's no normal tissue architecture, so the cells are usually undernourished. The doctor may apply some chemotherapeutic agent, which is an additional stress. So there are internal and external stress pathways that the cell has to cope with, and it is an advantage for the cancer cells to reactivate the autophagic process. And so it has been proposed that inhibition of autophagy would be a way to make the cancer cells more fragile and vulnerable to therapeutic intervention by chemotherapy, radiotherapy, targeted therapies. The problem is that nothing is simple in oncology, and that cancer is not just a cell autonomous disease. It is more. It is not just that one cell has become wild and has been accumulating genetic and epigenetic changes that make it selfish. No, a cancer cell will only survive if it escapes from immunosurveillance. So the immune system, fortunately for us, is usually very efficient in eliminating aberrant cells, pre-malignant cells, and the initial cancer cells. And actually, the inhibition of autophagy that occurs during early oncogenesis may be also a way for the cancer cells to hide from the immune system. And so it's this complex, it's immunology, multiple different players come into action. Autophagy, for instance, is required for stressed cells to release ATP into the microenvironment. You know, of course, ATP is the most important energy-rich metabolite in the cell. It's like the equivalent of the dollar for bioenergism clinics in the economy. And ATP, when it appears all of a sudden outside of the cell, is considered as non-physiological. It is a danger signal. It is perceived by so-called purinergic receptors that are present, among other cell types, on leukocytes, in particular myeloid cells. And a cell that undergoes autophagy may, especially when this occurs before cell death, release ATP to attract myeloid cells into its proximity and to start an immune response against tumor antigens in the context of the initial oncogenic events. And so autophagy is required for some steps of the immunosurveillance process. And it is exactly this process that makes cancer therapies efficient. So in contrast to the official dogma that has been en vogue for several decades, chemotherapy is not just killing the cancer cells as if we used an antibiotic that specifically paralyzes the metabolism of bacteria. No, it is true that chemotherapy induces cancer cell death, but the important point is that chemotherapy must provoke this cell death in a way that it later leads to an immune response. And so if you have a long-term effect of chemotherapy for years or decades that continues beyond removal of the drug, it is due to an anti-cancer immune response. And so, since this is so important, the capacity of the chemotherapeutic agent to induce autophagy is actually required for the long-term efficacy of the treatment.
I did not know that. I had no idea that the induction of autophagy would stimulate the immune system through this extracellular ATP mechanism.